Yesterday, I showed you a quick mock-up of the wireless switch and how to wire it. Today, I actually took a waterproof box and installed the switches into the box. Here's what I got. So before we get started, you're going to need a few things. This is a cable gland. This is what I used to run the wires from inside to outside of the box. This one is a size PG7. I will provide a link below. You're also going to need some Velcro. The box I use is from a company called Outdoor Products. Any waterproof box will work though. So these are my negative and positive wires that are going to run to the battery. I use quick disconnect plugs just to make it easier if I ever want to move this thing around. So now inside of the box, my power wire comes in and I have a fuse installed. After the fuse, the positive wire is ran to the positive terminal and the negative wire is ran to the negative terminal. Here you can see I have, from my positive terminal, I have a jumper ran to the B here, to the B here, to the B here, to the B there. That way all of these terminals have power. I have a power wire ran from each of the A's, and these are running outside of the box, and those are going to go to each set of lights that I want to control with the switch. Then I used another cable gland right here on the front for each of those four wires to run out of the box and to your LEDs. I also color coded them just using a little bit of electrical tape, so I can know which one corresponds to which button on the remote. So now that I have these four wires outside of the box, I can easily connect more wire to them and run them to wherever the LEDs are on my kayak. I used the Velcro on the bottom of the circuit board and Velcroed it to the bottom of the box. So the last thing is, I'm gonna use this Velcro. It's a little bit wider, it's a little bit more industrial. I'm going to put that on the bottom of the box and mount it inside the hole of my kayak. So I just wired it up quickly to these three LEDs just to kind of show you that it works. So I got my A that's running, got B, and then I got C. And I can turn it off, C, B, A. Now that it all works, it's ready to get rigged up in the kayak. So there you go. There's one way of using a waterproof box to rig it and mount it in the kayak. I'll be doing one more part to this video to actually show you how I put it in the kayak and where I put my LED lights and all that. Thanks again for watching, and stay tuned for more videos. And if you could, please subscribe to my YouTube channel.